breakfast.
Say, love you, Adam and Annie.
Love you, Adam and Annie.
When I think of Adam and Annie, I immediately think of PDA. I don't know any other couple who literally is almost always touching each other when they're together.
Sweet pea, apple of my eye.
But it's just so cute. It's like you want to hate it, but you love it because it's them and they totally own it and they're stuck together like glue.
Coming home.
Adam and Annie, this is Michael Fullman, the best man at your wedding. I want to congratulate you on the wedding. I look forward to celebrating with you, but why don't you have a little memento ahead of time? Funny story that I always knew was, Adam, when you first started dating her, you thought it would be cool to impress her by volunteering at a farmer's market in DuPont Circle at 7 a.m. on Saturday with her. I always thought you were crazy, but not that crazy, but I knew that you must love her a lot.
I wanna love you.
You know, Adam, it's all Fallman's fault. You realize if he hadn't have dragged you to that party that night, you never would have met Annie. And so, here you are with your soulmate, and we're so delighted with her and the upcoming wedding, and we wish you a great life together.
Congratulations on the wedding. I'm so happy you're finally getting married. Two of my best friends, and y'all are two peas in a pod, a perfect pair. So I know you're going to have a wonderful, beautiful life together, and wish you the best.
Annie and Adam are perfect for each other. They just have so much in common. They're such sweet, thoughtful, genuinely kind people, and they have so much fun together and are always laughing.
One thing they don't have in common, though, is the speed at which they eat. We'll now demonstrate a scene of Annie and Adam sitting down to a bowl of cereal together before work. I'll be playing Annie, and Liza will be playing Adam.
Strangest dream last night. I was walking on the beach and then a whale just jumped up and landed right in front of me. And I said, "Hello, Mr. Whale. What's your name?" And he said, "I don't know. What's your name? You look friendly." And I said, "Will you be my best friend?"
And he said,
that was rude. Adam, you've done it again.
When the road gets dark and you can no longer see, just let my love throw a spark and have a little faith in me.
Congratulations, my sweeties. Annie, I think from the minute I met you, I loved you. You are my daughter in my heart, and you make my son so very happy. And Ed, I see the love Annie has for you, and I know it has filled an empty space. To see you both so happy makes my heart just smile. Love you both.
Have a little faith in me.
I guess it's your rehearsal dinner. Thank you so much to the Turks for having this lovely event. Delilah, who couldn't be part of your wedding, wanted to say hi, and she was my sidekick as your wedding planner, and it was such an honor being your wedding planner. Guys, you two are the best. I love you both, and I know you're going to have a great day tomorrow.
When I think of Adam and Annie, I think of two incredible people. But I also think how incredible it is that the two of them can accomplish everything that they need to in a typical day. As Adam's brother-in-law, I was first exposed to his pace of life 17 years ago, and he's the only person I know that can find a way to brush his teeth for 30 minutes, 5 minutes before we're supposed to be somewhere. But I think a lot of it has to do with the fact he uses a tongue scraper. And then I met sweet Annie, and although I don't know if she uses a tongue scraper, let's be honest, she's in no hurry to get from point A to point B either. Have you guys ever taken a walk with them? A 30-minute walk can easily turn into a 60-minute walk. You gotta stop once for a hug, another time for an Eskimo kiss, a couple of back rubs. But you know what? It's one of the little quirks that makes them perfect for each other. Do not be late for the wedding, you two.
Adam and Annie, congratulations today on your wedding. We're all so happy for you both, and we love you both very much. Annie, welcome to our family. It's my duty as Adam's favorite cousin for now over 30 years to remind you all my first memory of Adam at a wedding, and that was at Becca's wedding when Adam mistakenly grabbed a plate to place on his head as a little funny gesture, and he actually happened to grab the butter plate, and he got butter all over his hair, and it really created a scene and frankly almost ruined the whole evening for us all.
The first time that I ever met Annie was when I applied to be a research associate at the Environmental Law Institute, and Annie was in charge of the hiring process. And I remember of all five different rounds of interviews with attorneys, the one that I was most intimidated by was the interview with all of the current research associates, including Annie. And looking back, it's really funny to think about being intimidated by Annie in any way, shape, or form. But I'm so glad that she chose me and that we became friends. And Annie, I'm so excited to be sharing this day with you and Adam, and I wish you all the best. I'm gonna fix this world up for you.
Hey Adam and Annie, we are so happy for you and excited for the big day. I knew you two are perfect for each other with your communist leanings and soft silky skin.
And Annie, I'm super excited to have you for a sister finally. And we're just really excited to go ahead and experience all of the memories that we're going to have with you guys over the next years to come. Love you guys.
Congratulations, so excited for your wedding.
Congratulations! Hi, my name is Rob, and I am Annie Brock's yoga and Pilates instructor. Anyways, I just want to wish Annie and Adam all the best. We love them both dearly. Annie is a wonderful, sweet girl, and as you know, just a barrel of laughs, and we all think she's kind of a cross between Joan Rivers and Chelsea Handler.
This is Annie's aunt, Belinda. But I do want to talk to you, Annie. It's been wonderful watching you mature from a sweet little girl into a confident, loving woman. I've really admired how you followed your passions wherever they've led you, and they've taken you all over the globe. We're thrilled that one of your passions is Adam. You two make a great couple, and we wish you only good things in your future together.
This is my kind of town, Chicago is.
We wrote a little poem for you guys. So we want to wish Annie and Adam love for now and later, even though our rhymes lack iambic pentameter.
So from syntax to diction to our poor linguistics, we wanted to celebrate the two of you and your wonderful characteristics.
Although you Bracks grew up in New York and us in the Midwest, our strong family ties have survived the geographical test.
We wish you love, happiness, and good fortune to boot to a wonderful couple that is loving and obviously cute.
It's my kind of town.
So Annie and Adam, on behalf of the entire Chicago Brock family, mazel tov and congratulations.
Congrats, you kids. Wish you all the happiness and health and love in your entire life.
Adam, my buddy, we spent every day together as a child, and now we hardly ever get to even see each other, but it doesn't change the fact that we're still close friends and think about you all the time. And Annie, you won me over from the first time we met there when you guys had just started dating, so I couldn't be happier for you guys.
One of my favorite memories of Adam was when we were backpacking together in the Greek
islands, and they went to an island called Eos, where Homer was buried. And Adam was very adamant that we needed to go to the gravesite, and Fallman and myself could have cared less. But we ended up renting scooters and making our way towards the gravesite, and Adam was really excited about it. And on the way there, he was about 50 yards in front of me, and the terrain had gotten a little bit rocky, and he ended up wiping out with a big plume of dust flying into the air. And it was signature Adam to be all upset, mad, and bloodied, and it was all because we wanted to follow his desire to go there. Don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you got till
it's gone? It'd be a paradise, put up a fucking line. I just wanted to cheers to a wonderful couple and say how happy I am for you. And Annie, I was thinking we've certainly come a long way since our days at Northwestern with the juice and the keg and Dillo Day and 825 Simpson and all of our shenanigans. But I'm so glad that we did go through it all. And honestly, without Northwestern, we wouldn't have met MJ. And without MJ, you wouldn't have gone to the birthday party at Santa Rosa in Washington, D.C., where you met your lovely fiancé, soon-to-be husband.
I have to say, Adam, you are getting one heck of a roommate. Annie, as we all know, is amazing, and I'm so jealous that you get to live with her. I will say, Annie, I hope that you have graduated from your desktop where you used to pull all-nighters while I was asleep to a laptop. I hope you pull fewer all-nighters, and I hope that you don't study for quite as many science tests. But other than that, Adam, Annie's amazing, and I'm so jealous that you guys are starting your life together. And Annie, Adam, I'm also can't wait to have him in our little family. So congratulations to both of you. Hey, hey, paradise, you
put up a parking lot. Woohoo! I'm so excited for you guys. Annie, I'm just so glad you're finally going to be my sister. It's felt like you have been ever since I met you in D.C. that summer. Thank you so much for helping me. I'll never forget it. Adam and Annie, you guys are just wonderful people. You're a wonderful couple, and you're a great example of what it takes to make a relationship work no matter what's going on in your lives. And I just wanted to say thank you. Thank you for always being there for me as well, and I hope you know I'm always here for you guys. Here's to many years of happiness and love and laughter for you too, and can't wait to see what the future brings.
As Annie's brother, I would like to think that I have some insight into Annie after 30 years of living with her or knowing her. And let me say this, that some things have come and gone and changed over the years, but there's three constants. Number one, the bangs. Go back to her photographs from when she was 3 or 4 or 5 years old, and you'll notice that even then, that is her most prominent fashion feature as it is today. Number two, sweets, which is surprising because she's not that big. She's like 18 pounds and kind of slight of frame, and you wouldn't think she'd be able to pack it all down, but she has many a time taken food out of my mouth to put down hers. So she loves the sweets. And number three, she always has this kind of glint in the eye, like she knows something that you don't know. And you know when it comes out the most is when she's with Adam. When the two of them are looking at each other, it's like they're communicating in their own language. And I think that's a pretty good indication that you know that they are meant for each other, because it's like no one else in the world exists. And you just know that it's the right person and the right time. And both of you, I'm so happy for you. Love you both. Congratulations. God only knows what I'd be without you. If you should ever leave me, the life would still go on, believe me. The world could show nothing to me. So what good would living do me? God only knows what I'd be without you. What?